Welcome to Wellness by All Means Live Forum. So we are going to interview one of our close friends, Mr. Damodar Sahu. So let me just talk briefly about him. Damodar has been a good friend who have been here in the Bay Area, in the Silicon Valley. But now he has moved to Troy, Michigan, another part of the US. And he hails from a place that is very close. It's a place called Belagunta in Odisha. It's a rural Odisha. So we'll try to talk about his venture, how in the lockdown time, what he thought about and what he created, something very meaningful for all of us when it comes to giving back to the world. In fact, the word that he used is called PSR, just like we all know CSR, the corporate social responsibilities. So he has been saying something about PSR, personal social responsibilities. So he is an IT professional, works in the emerging technologies like IoT and artificial intelligence. So it's a great experience for him to come from Belagunta to Bay Area and to Troy, Michigan. He has been a lot of journey in this life. So let's try to welcome him and see what he's there for us. Welcome, Damodar. How are you?
Thank you, Manoj bhai. I'm good. And good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Pleasure to be with you, Manoj bhai. Yeah.
Very nice. I think I've seen you, as much as I know, you are a very passionate, very jovial, clean and just excited about anything. So we just did a small play just to talk about how COVID-19 happened. So that was good. Like, your excitement is always there. So that's great. So tell us a little bit more about, like, how has been the journey so far? Like, the journey that I started from Belagunta to Bay Area, as you said, like, all the time that I've seen it. So tell us a little bit more about your childhood time, because a lot of people may not know about how, in rural Odisha, we start our life, and then what happens during that time. So what are the challenges that you faced? Just give us a little bit more background.
Yes. Thank you. good point. Belagunta to Bay Area. Now Belagunta to Bay Area and to Troy, Michigan.
I say myself from Kalahandi to California.
Kalahandi to California. Awesome. Great. So I think Belagunta to Bay Area, I like this word. And of course, now in East Coast, Michigan.
Right.
Life is really beautiful. I can say I'm truly blessed. And Belagunta is especially in Ganjam district. We call it Bhanjabhumi San, right? Bhumusara San, I call it. It's close to both Fulbani, then Kalahandi will come once
right.
You cross that Kalinga
Ghati. Right.
Kalinga Ghati.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So my childhood is very, very memorable. If you ask me about let me talk about my Janmabhumi first, where I am born. Though my father was migrated from undivided Puri district, a place called Gambharimunda, Padmapur, near Banapur, Natsuni.
Mm.
But my nephew, I am born in Belagunta. So I always say I am a Ganjamia and Belaguntia. So if you see the history of Belagunta, Belagunta was a main market place for grocery and cattle in Ganjam district. This famous is also, this place is world famous for brass fish. We call it Pittala Matsa in the world.
Wow.
And Nrisimhanath temple is one of the significant temple in this region that attracts thousands of pilgrims to get a darshan of Lord Lakshmi Nrisimha. And one of the Bhanja king from Bhanja dynasty, mm-hmm. I think they had established the temple during 18th century. I will come back to my childhood.
Right.
And Belagunta was the business destination for people. That's why we call it Pentha. Pentha is called a gathering place where people will come and do some business, right? And all grocery, corns, vegetable, etc. used to come from Baud and Fulbani for selling into that market.
Right.
And it was a business hub in that region earlier. And Belagunta itself is famous for art and culture with brass, silver, copper, and woodwork. And
right.
I told you the world famous brass piece. Are this still main attraction of the city? There was a story about the brass piece.
Mm-hmm.
The brass fish used to swim in water for several minutes to entertain the king and queen those days.
Wow.
So that's why, And Belagunta is the main, we call it the 3T. So one is temple, teachers, and tanks, that ponds, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's why you call it 3T. We also call it temple city, city of ponds or tanks, right? And so it's a education hub in this region nowadays. So my childhood was really very, very interesting. I'm truly blessed, and I was a good student. I used to study well, and standard 3, standard 5, 7th NTSC, all these scholarship in third and fifth, even 10th also national scholarship. And I stood in district number 1 in 10th in 1990. Right. And I was, I think, best 15th in Orissa State in 1990. So that is how. After that, then I moved out of Belagunta. I did my higher study. Then corporate life started. You know, I'll talk about that in the moment.
Right.
The good part of the Belagunta is it's a very education-centric, people-centric. People are good, though it's a small village. It's not a small village. If you see, it is a NAC, Notified Area Council, in 1975.
Right.
But because of the neighboring region, let's say Bhanjanagar is a subdivision, Aska is also one. So that's why it is in between Bhanjanagar and Aska. So that's why this is not so highlighted. It is still keeping low profile.
Right. So you mentioned about, you had a little bit struggle in the childhood time, like because of poverty and stuff like that. We all come through like that. And you also mentioned like a lot of people in the village, like almost the postmaster and other people raised you. Like we always say like it takes a village to raise a child, a good child, like you. So how was that experience? Like, did you feel, very intimate with everyone in the village? Was it like we talk about global village right now, but you really come from a true village where you can see that love and affection for everyone, you know, that neighborhood culture. So tell us a little bit more about like how was that upbringing and what impression did it create in your mind?
Absolutely. Whatever I am today, I owe to my village. All credit goes to them. And childhood was a little bit struggle, especially for me, especially poverty. And my father was one of the best social worker in my village, but he was not doing good in business. And no complaint. That is how I am here. And yes, as I was studying well, I was a good student. And I was always, my standard 1 to standard 10, I always stood 1. And there are a lot of affectionate from my neighbor to my police officer to state bank manager to my primary school headmaster, all teachers, all my madams, I can name them, Vipracharan Mishra, Saibani Das, Saudamini Das, I lost few teachers recently, even a MME school teacher, my high school headmaster, Sri Haigarbha Tripathi, who is in Brahmapur, and all the teachers, I can name few, and all my books, tuition, everything was free of cost for me, because I was one of the good students. Not only I was studying well, I was doing the Bakrita Patijogita. I used to sing well. I used to dance well as well. And lot of nataks, stage show used to do those days. And my friends, you can't imagine, friends like, let's say, the son of, let's say, the panchayat sarpanch or the NSC chairman. And they used to sponsor my meals, and they used to sponsor my volleyball, football, cricket, those days were very crazy. And we used to have a SS bet. I can't even pay 1 rupee, but my friends, they will sponsor my donation. Wow. So that is what I did. And as I didn't have any proper lighting system, no electricity in my house. So I used to go and study in my friend's place.
Not under the life post, like what
landlord. No, not under the life post. I'm talking about early 90s, early 80s. So
I remember like using that kerosene lantern.
Lantern.
You take that and then you go to school. You go to tuition. Like, particularly, it's very interesting to think about those moments, like how those struggleful moments are also very memorable right now. You feel good
about it. That is also one of the reasons why I got my eyesight early. Early since after 10th only. The moment I get into the college, then I found, I'm not able to see. Then I realized, yes. Because I used to learn. In those days, used to go to bed by 8:30, 9 o'clock. I remember my mom used to say, hey, wake up, it is 3 a.m. in the morning. And there was no wristwatch or wall clock or something. Right. Nothing was there in my home. So I used to get up and dress up. And there was no public toilet as well. No personal toilet as well. We used to go out and use public toilet or go to, right? So it was interesting moment, I can say. It is always, I cherish my childhood. And even I was talking about, you know, how my friends, you know, let's say son of our public healthcare doctor, then son of Krishnachandra Bhuiya. So he's one of my best friend. His father was the state bank manager in my place, Belagunta. I used to study in his house. And the Mausa, Mausi and all his siblings, they were so affectionate. Even they don't allow me to come to my home and have a food. I used to there in, I think, 8th, 9th, 10th, I can say. And so it was a very fond memory. And not only I can name only few, I mean, across. I remember I even didn't have a shoe, proper shoe. And but I have a very old cycle. And the moment I will go to high school, close to 1 kilometer from my place, and the moment I will go, people used to look at me and say, hey, he's Damodar.
I know, it's so exciting about, like, you know, having not having too many things, but having those little things, and then being so proud about having those positions, like, you know, having a new pant or a new shirt, new pen or new book that you get. So all this newness was really rekindling the spirit of life in those times. So coming back to the topic that we are also talking right now, during the lockdown time, you said like your heart opened up for a new idea and you did something great for your, you know, Matrubhumi or like your motherland, particularly the village that you talked about, in the memory of your father. You called something called Mulika Smarak, Mulya Smarak, like in the memory of your father. So tell us a little bit more about that PSR experience that you had, like, you know, in just in May, during this time, lockdown time itself, like you started that project and you instituted something great in your school. So tell us a little bit more about that Mulya Smarak project that you did.
Yeah. My father's name is Mulya Sahu, so people fondly call him Mulya. And I lost him in 2012. People call him Mama. So if you go to my village, ask, do you know Mulya Mama? I mean, he's Mama of the village, right? For anything, he will be there. So the lockdown is really very helpful to me. And I was just thinking, you know, what is the purpose of life, right? And I thought the purpose of life is, if you are not able to help anybody, then, I mean, who will help? If you don't love yourself, then you can't love others, right? Then I thought, okay, this is the opportunity. It was there somewhere in my back of my mind, but it was not able to I was not able to materialize it. And I thought this is the right time, and I'm in US, and I have seen how poverty is, and I have come across that. And as my father has a fond towards education, and I have also very little bit inclined towards education, then I thought, let me create a smarak. Smarak means memorial. No trust. If trust, then you have to go for all the registration and all. If you are doing a memorial scholarship, no registration required. I talked to a couple of my legal friends. And then I put Mulya Smarak. MulyaSmarak.org also I've created one thing. And website. And I thought, let me put some of my personal fund and let's say 7%, 8% interest, whatever you're getting. And whatever the interest you get for a year. And let me fund, help you people in need. You know, especially my village people to start with, right?
Right.
And to fulfill it, I have created a core group in my village. Let's say Satish Reddy is one of my junior brother, right? And one Om Prakash Sahu. Then we have an advisor, Dasabhana we call it, right? He's a retired from Air Force, now an income tax officer in Bangalore. So he's advisor on ground. And so how that will work, so people will reach out to us or we will reach out to them proactively. Hey, do you need any support? So then if they are studying well, don't have anything to for their study, then we will fund maybe one-time expenses or maybe a registration fee, hostel fee, whatever the way. And that has come out well and it is circulated in my village. They know that. And the first set of benefices are coming in September. So we have shortlisted one girl, one boy from Belagunta. And I think their registration is on. So we'll fund them, you know, based on
that. Very good. I think it's basically like, you know, what feels like, because you had a little struggle in the childhood time and then a lot of villagers, like everybody helped you unconditionally. So now that triggered a point in your heart, like, hey, why don't I give it back to the same school or the same village where it can help a lot of poor people, like particularly. So you instituted a personal fund, like a corpus fund kind of thing, and then based on the interest, some money will be given annually to some poor deserving students. And do you also have any plan to help them out in terms of guiding them, like mentoring them? Because just giving financial money is one thing, but encouraging them, inspiring them, exposing them to new ideas, new responsibilities, new leadership possibilities. Have you also thought about adding some other components? to that project?
Yes, yes. So I talked to both the boy and girl recently, and I though that they know about me, but they never saw me. So I was on a video call, audio call. I talked to them about me, you know, how I struggle, how I am really come across that stage. They really got excited, and I told them, please study and no, don't worry about this. You know, it will come automatically. You know, I have not mentioned one of my senior, 4 years senior to me, Pradyumna Charan Pradyumna Bhaina, Satpati Bhaina. He used to send me money order every month, 300 rupees goes just to my hostel. So this is one of the great thing he did it actually. You know, he's a nice human being. So guys, I mean, I always say my nothing. It's just obstacle. We need to just pass it on. I mean, right? Just let it
go. You're so passionate about giving back, because you know, if you look at life in general, like you think about relationships that we have, which are a loved one in our family. Think about the relationship of a mother to her children. Think about the relationship of a parent to their children. Think about the student teacher relationship. If you look at all the relationships, I believe relationship gets stronger and stronger when somebody wants to give it back, not take in, not take away. When you give back more and more, I think every relationship really thrives. So that's what I've seen in my own family also, in my own life also. Like, you have to give it back more. So same thing happens to our motherland. Like, whatever that we come from, if you want to go give back, that fills up our heart. That kind of also purifies our wealth. You know, it really, like, for example, like, now may I ask you, like, you know, when you go back to your village right now, you know, after the COVID-19, whenever you go back to India and your village, how do you experience, how do you feel that excitement? Like, when those children will come and then greet you, or anybody, and you look at the school, what excitement will you have?
Absolutely. I mean, we do all reunion, and whenever I go, first thing I go to my UP school, ME school, high school, I always see who are my friends available there. I go meet them, go along with them. And we used to discuss, okay, and the young boys and girls, they will come, oh, you are Damodar Bhaina, right? And I will always say, yeah, I'm here, how are you doing, this, that. And coming back to the question which you asked, I will finish it maybe 1 minute. Hey. I want to create a chain reaction. Let's say 1 to 3 to 9 to 27, 81 kind of school happen, right? So I want to, otherwise you alone cannot do everything, right? So if you are able to support somebody, and let that guy support two guys, you know, or three guys. So that chain reaction should happen in a positive way. So that actually I want to create it. Even we have a plan in September that I will address a big conference to all those students pass out of this year. And I heard that close to 95% people have passed out, and I think 80% are all first division. So that is also I want to do them and encourage them. Yeah.
And then I also like the idea of, like, because out of all the different ways, you might have created some plants, you might have created some buildings and infrastructure, but you chose education, because education is one of the biggest things that we can give, particularly, like, you know, when we have got a lot of ambitions, particularly in the rural areas, wherever you have, unless you build a stronger foundation by giving them proper education, the real development will not happen. Right? That's why I believe you chose education compared to any other thing that you could have done with that, you know, Smarak.
Yeah, absolutely, because of that reason, yeah. Because I have come across how difficult it was for me, right. You know, and right. I thought to at least, yeah.
And I think, you know, all those families, if you look back, like, you know, when people are having that foresight, like, you know, all the grandpas and all, they have really laid out a stronger foundation for their children and grandchildren for education. Those families have really stood outstanding, you know, not just people who just make money, but people who really make education as the main priority. And that is why, you know, this noble cause that you are promoting of giving back to your motherland, giving back to your poor village that you come from. So all those things are a lot of meaningful things right now, particularly in this time of, you know, rat race and a lot of competition and stuff like that. But when you really reflect on your life journey, as you said, the purpose of life to give back, definitely I think it's a very, very noble cause. That you have been pursuing. So we would like to wish you all the best in your journey. And I'm really excited about, you know, just looking at you, your innocence, and then you just like the life itself. Like, give it back, and then live life every moment. So when you give back, your heart opens up, your soul cleanses itself. And I strongly believe in that. So I will definitely wish you all the best in that journey. And also, it will create the chain reaction that you're thinking about. So many schools will get inspired. Many people, in fact, like, I'm also thinking about a project, like, you know, where we adopt your block or your small village, and then go do something great about it. So we'll talk more about like how you will groom the new students that become the beneficiary of the scholarship that you have instituted in your school. And we'd like to see like if we can interview one of your graduates from the school.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you very much. And I will see you again.
Thank you. Thank you, bye. Thank you very much. Yeah.